normally room air contains 21% oxygen and remaining air is nitrogen. Oxygen concentrator is a device which sucks in the room air, concentrates and purifies the air and provides the oxygen which is 90% and above, which is prescribed medically. Normally anything more than 95% is considered normal. So 90 to 94 considered mild to moderate hypoxia. Anything below 90 is considered severe hypoxia. Pulse oximetry is a small handheld device which has two parts. One is light emitting diode and the other part is sensor. The light emitting diode emits two wavelengths of the light which passes through the finger, wherein the oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood differentially absorbs this light and computes the oxygen saturation in the blood, and sensor gives the value of our oxygen saturation, which is 95% and above is considered normal. The need for oxygen has to be determined by the treating doctor. Treating doctor has to understand what is the patient's condition. So there are two spectrum of situation where we can use the oxygen concentrator. So in the initial part of the disease, where the patient is not sick enough, can be managed at home, but he needs supplemental oxygen. If a doctor has seen, assessed him and assessed his severity and decided that he can be given medication and a supplemental oxygen at home, and he can be managed at home. But without the consultation of a doctor, without the monitoring of a doctor, taking an oxygen at home can be counterproductive, because we will never know how the disease progresses. So if the doctor has assessed and assessed the severity and given the oxygen, it is useful. The other spectrum of the disease spectrum where the oxygen concentrator indicated is when the patient was admitted with a severe condition, got better and he is recovering, but he is needing supplemental oxygen. Only for the supplemental oxygen he is staying in the hospital. In that situation, he can be given medications at home and the supplemental oxygen, where the requirement is low flow oxygen, which can be effectively provided through the oxygen concentrator. As I already told you, it depends on the doctor's assessment about the patient's condition and its severity. Oxygen is a drug. It has to be prescribed by a doctor, and doctor should know the severity and the reasonably he should know the natural history of the disease. In strict sense, there is nothing like a disinfection of the oxygen concentrator. So we need to change the distilled water which is used periodically or regularly intervals, and the tubings what we use to provide oxygenation has to be cleaned periodically with a mild soap water, because the moisture which is remained in the tubing can be a source of fungal growth. I just mentioned about the distilled water. The distilled water should be used for the humidification, where the oxygen goes to the patient. That way, it means the humidification of the respiratory tract. Setting the flow rate in the oxygen concentrator has to be entirely depends on the patient's condition and prescription by the doctor. Generally, as I told you, the oxygen is a drug. It has to be prescribed. As every drug has the side effects, even oxygen given for a long time and a higher quantity has its own problems. That's why the oxygen rate has to be prescribed by the doctor, and that should be maintained. It depends on the patient's condition and the doctor's prescription. Normally, when you are giving the long-term oxygen therapy or home therapy, generally we advise at least 16 hours a day. However, this is slightly different in COVID-19 scenario, where the patient may need the oxygen for 24 hours a day. Again, it depends upon the patient's other symptoms like fever, cough, breathlessness, along with the oxygen pulse oximeter reading, which is consistently above 95 without oxygen, is an indicator the patient has got better. If oxygen saturation is less than 95 or between 90 to 95, he needs oxygen support, but it is improvement or deterioration of the patient condition has to be assessed along with the other symptoms of fever and other symptoms associated in that particular disease. Anybody who is less than 90% indicates a severe disease. He needs to be hospitalized and assessed accordingly. as I was telling you, if the person's saturation is more than 95 without oxygen, that means to say if the patient's condition is improved and he doesn't need a supplemental oxygen. As I told you, oxygen is a drug. The long-term oxygen has its own problem, starting with the simple problems like drying of the nasal mucosa or the crusting of the secretions, headache, and heavy-headed feeling. These are all the minor problems associated with taking oxygen for a longer period. COVID-19 is not over yet. We need to continue to follow all COVID-appropriate behavior, mask yourselves, use sanitizer frequently, avoid the crowd, maintain the social distancing, stay home, stay safe.